and they are aware of what is occurring in that type. So at this point in time, I'm just gonna give the word of prayer. Let us pray. Our kind
say, do not take an offering.
Who come to your throne of grace in this prayer.
But they have an offering prayer.
That you have given to us freely. We consider it a blessing indeed. Many of our friends do not have the chance to live up to this day. Some have died. Some are running to and fro because of various calamities and wars. Therefore, Lord, we pray to them that we have indeed made it in this very special supper. We pray that God, as we are retaining our tithes and offerings, we ask that God may you bless the hands of those who are going to retain the tithes and offerings. And even those that do not have the money or any other thing that I can retain, we ask that God may you let them go. In the mighty name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Amen. Open our hymns to hymn number 83, O Worship the King. Shall we all stand and sing together?
Perfectly. Therefore, we are happy, and therefore we thank God.
Thank you.
That's it. Last time we rent that Smart, it cost $93.
This time it only cost me 19 or something. I only got 12 cans because it's got 15 more. So it's got lots of food now.
And Carl at Walmart was so helpful as a personal shopper. Thank you, Carl. And thank you, Dodie. What building is that over there, do you know?
Target.
Oh. And this is Route 151.
Yeah.
In quick putting it together, I pulled some frozen bread out of the freezer downstairs and some grape juice, and praise the Lord. I don't like to postpone it to another week. We're not going to. We're going to celebrate now, and just to let you know that if we need to do it with water, we can do it with water. Anything symbolizing the body and the blood of Christ will work in terms of doing the liturgy and sharing that communal experience. Yes. Oh, thank you, Janet. Due to the fact that two reasons here. Some complaints have been made about the length of our service. I reevaluated and tried to make some shortcuts. And, I really don't want to shut down the time that we spend in worship. If I hear it's a universal complaint, occasionally we go, although I was told it was four Sundays in Rome. But in any case, time of the Lord is not at limited from where I stand. And if you do need to leave ahead of time, I trust that you will just tiptoe and we'll see you on the following Sunday. In any case, I will also, on the other end of the ladder, do my best to limit it to 1 hour of service. But we did have a longer service this morning at the other church, so on the way here, Janet suggested that we limit the singing of all hymns to the first and last verse, and not what is mentioned in the listed in the bulletin. So we will follow that procedure. Yes, Glendora?
I like the length of the service. I like our order of worship. I think it's perfect. And I go to a lot of churches, and I really think that it's perfect. I like it. I'm sorry today that I'm going to leave early.
Oh, Glendora. It's going to have a change, sorry.
But we do have a saint in northern New York. We have a Saint Catery. She was converted to Christianity in the 1600s at Aurisville, and she became in danger of the other Indians, so they moved her to Fonda. And so a whole group of us from the Roman Catholic Church are going today to Fonda, to where she lived the last years of her life, St. Catery, an American Indian.
Okay, we'll look forward to hearing a report on that, Glendora. Okay?
I didn't hear you, I'm sorry.
We'll look forward to hearing your report on your experience. Any other announcements this morning? If not, let us worship God together, and let us begin by using the responsive call to worship as we find it there in our bulletin. We come together to live for you and for each other, O God.
We come together to learn with you and each other.
We come together to listen to you and to each other.
And to love today and every day with all our hearts, soul, and mind, and strength.
Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. Let us pray in unison the prayer before beginning our worship as we find it printed in the bulletin. Let us pray. God, who guides the sun and the moon and the stars through their places. God, who makes sparrow on the walls. God, who feeds the creatures of the deeps. And provides the food for your creatures on the mountaintops and in the valley of the valleys. We humbly request your presence. Our responsorial reading is printed in the bulletin. It is based on Psalm 107, which reviews God's actions and the experiences of the people at that time. And as you read, as we read the psalm responsibly, I would ask you to heed the opening remarks and the closing response in that reading. They share with us the psalmist's appeal to us that we trust in the steadfast love of God. Oh, give thanks to the God who is good and whose steadfast love endures forever.
Oh, give thanks to God who is good and whose steadfast love endures forever.
Let the redeemed say so, for we have been redeemed from trouble, gathered together from the lands, from the east and from the west, from the north and from the south.
Oh, give thanks to God who is good and whose steadfast love endures forever.
We have wandered in desert wastes, finding no way to an inhabited town. Hungry and thirsty, our soul fainted within us. Then we cried to heaven in our trouble, and we were delivered from our distress.
Lead us by the straight way. Bring us to your city. We thank you for your steadfast love, for your wonderful works for all humankind.
Satisfy the thirsty. Fill the hungry with good things. Let those who are wise give heed to these things and consider God's steadfast love.
Amen.
Let us sing together hymn number 91, stanzas 1 and 5. Jesus, Thou Joy of Loving Hearts. Believe these words and go forth to live in peace. And remember always the words of our Lord Jesus Christ when he said that you should love the Lord your God with all of your heart, all of your soul, and all of your mind. This is the great and the first commandment. And a second is like it. You shall love your neighbor as yourself. On these two commandments depend all of the law and the prophets.
That railroad train, I rode that train every Friday night and every Monday morning. WRGV Channel 6 Schenectady, Buffalo to Schenectady. Schenectady. It isn't there anymore. What? the railroad ride. It was New York Central. It's gone. Those things are gone. Well, it bothers me that she's not around.
Well, I think the fact she's not hungry is just not.
Well, hi, Barb.
Hi, Glendora.
How are you? Hi, Joanne.
How are you doing?
Good, thanks.
Good.
It was a nice ride, wasn't it? It took an hour and 20 minutes.
That's how long we were trying to.
We didn't remember when we left.
Yeah, we left a quarter of, a little before.
Row?
Yeah, 20 between the yellow.
They did that at Ari.